my friend Gerhard here to introduce to you. He is a great horned owl, and he is a male. He was hurt because he was hit by a car, and that happens very often. Now, if you would notice, Gerhard's wing on this side is deformed. This is what was broken. What happens is their bones are fragile. They're like hollow, thin macaroni. And instead of breaking and snapping like a human bone, when they could mend again, their bones shatter like dropping a glass. And this is the best his wing could be put back together. Gerhard's senses are really highly tuned visual and auditory. He's got disc feathers. They're called facial disc feathers. They look like little saucers, satellite dishes. And that brings light into their eyes at night. And it also brings sound. Their ears are holes in their head like human ears. And they're right here behind where the facial disc feathers end. But in the dark, this bird can stand up in the top of a tall tree and hear a mouse under leaves or a foot of snow. And he uses the sound first to find prey. Their eyes are, as you notice, very large. They're the size of an adult eyeball. Now my eyes have muscles, ocular muscles that can make them move. He does not. His eyes are so large, they're locked into bones. So instead what he has are 7 extra vertebrae, and as you see what he's doing, they could turn their head very rapidly, about 270 degrees. So be like from 12 o'clock all the way back around to 9 and do it fast right and left to make up for that. Underneath all of his wing feathers and tail feathers, very soft, fluffy down to keep them totally silent. And at the end of all these feathers, they look like your eyelashes so that the air can flow through. Therefore, owls, especially one this large, have totally silent flight. People often mistake these as ears. Those are just called tufts. They are feathers. He can't control them. About half of the owls have tufts. The others do not. He uses those for several things. He can communicate like sign language with his partner or another owl and express either I'm good, I'm happy, it's okay, or anger or upset or frightened. If you notice his feet, he's got very large and extremely powerful feet. He can swoop and grab a large rabbit just instantly and no problem at all to take off with it. He's got 4 toes. Typically the owls have 2 in front, 2 in the back, but he also can, it's called an opposable, he can bring one in the back to the front, so when he's hunting, he has all 3 toes to the front to grab food. The great horned owl covers most of North American continent, just shy stopping of the upper part of Canada, all the way down into Mexico and Central America, and then the eastern coast of South America, mainly like in the Brazil area. And they're pretty much on their own as far as the species go. You may find a great horned owl in your backyard if you have the tree line and the open fields for him, but chances are you'll hear him first. And a good way to find them is to walk under trees in your area and look for the whitewash, pellets, and perhaps dead animal scraps at the bottom. To wrap up our Gerhard, he's an amazing, powerful, very dominant bird who rules the roost, but he's a joy to have and to get to know.